some peace tonight in the arms of the angel. Fly away from here, from this dark, cold hotel room and the endlessness that you fear.
We're doing a transnational level project for our third world feminism class to break the boundaries between first and third world women. Our class is structured around this project, and it isn't just an added component. Third world feminism is also most oftenly misconstrued, with people thinking that women just strictly from the third world are involved, when really it is of women today and them struggling to get their voices heard.
To quote Gloria Enzaldúa, "The U.S.-Mexican border is an open wound where the third world grates against the first and bleeds. And before a scab forms, it hemorrhages again. The lifeblood of two worlds merging to form a third country, a border culture. Borders are set up to define the places that are safe and unsafe, to distinguish us from them."
Many of the ideas and theories that arise from our study of the Juarez murder and our transnational access project have underpinnings that are applicable to all women throughout the third world. The Juarez femicides are just one case highlighting the expendability of women, the process of othering, and the power of oppression in the hands of a dominant economy, all of which exist throughout the third world. The goal of this transnational access project is to break the silence about these murders while also decolonizing the constructions of the physical and ideological border that exists on the U.S.-Mexico border, the historical systems of oppression, and the process of othering, all of which have facilitated and fueled the continuation of the exploitation and expendability of the women of Juarez. One of the reasons our project is so important is because people are completely silenced to this issue. They don't know where Juarez is.
No idea where Juarez is.
No, I do not know where Juarez is.
They don't know what a mutilador is.
I don't know what that is.
Wait, that's the... I think a maquiladora is someone who fights...
No, a maquiladora.
They don't know what NAFTA is or its implications. They don't know about free trade.
I do not know anything about a NAFTA. Free trade is when maybe countries or countries specifically trade between... They trade their goods and they don't charge me any type of tax for it.
The web of complicity is composed symbolically of all of the different strands that represent the underlying systems of oppression. The web is woven together where these systems of oppression intersect to form this whole web of oppression which oppresses women, not only of the third world, but throughout both worlds.
NAFTA was created by the United States, and it's a treaty between the U.S., Canada, and Mexico that eliminates tariffs on foreign imports and exports, which has spurred foreign investments in places like Mexico, where foreign companies come and create maquiladoras, which will pay low wages to women for long hours of work.
In this case, the border acts to separate Mexicans from Americans, acts as a boundary that limits who or what can cross the border. It's really just sort of a political construction that's beneficial to Americans, but detrimental to Mexicans. American employers, these huge American companies, they can cross the border and establish huge maquiladoras. The cheap goods they create, those can cross the border, you know, they're very beneficial to the American economy. But the women who make them, these Mexican women working the maquiladoras, they can't cross the border. They don't have the right.
One of our major sources of activist inspiration was Alicia Gaspar de Alba's Desert Blood.
In Desert Blood, Gaspar de Alba chooses to make her antagonist and her villain the Lone Ranger. Traditionally, the Lone Ranger in American history has represented the protector of the frontier, our hero. But in Desert Blood, Gaspar de Alba makes him the villain. He's the one who's responsible for all of the murders and for allowing all the murders to continue. This is how she's using pop culture against itself. In a way, she's symbolically representing Americans as the Lone Ranger. We are the Lone Rangers, each one of us as responsible as the next.
American companies are able to employ women, and it's primarily women because of the kind of work they think women are better at it. And they're able to pay very low salaries, very low wages. They have no benefits to speak of. And these women come in from the countryside, so they are living in cardboard and paper shacks out on the edges of the desert, miles from where they're working. Buses come and pick them up and drop them off, sometimes a mile away. They're prey to people who want to prey on them and murder them. And that's primarily where it's happening, coming to and from.
The authorities in Juarez are pretty much not even present in this issue. I know the head of the Juarez police has been arrested. There's many accusations that they are directly involved in letting all these murders happen. And the Juarez authorities are also a direct reflection of the economy, where the officers and officials care more about the goods that these women produce than the actual lives of these women.